Seeing your projects and calendar in a timeline format can give you a great view on the progression of your tasks, schedules, and projects. Notion is a wonderful tool for displaying your information in a timeline view, and in this video, we wanted to cover everything about timeline view databases from beginner to more advanced tips. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first thing we wanted to show you is all the ways you can use to create a timeline view in Notion. So the first way is by adding it as an inline database. So that means that if you hit return and then slash timeline, you can basically create a timeline view inside of a Notion page like this. And you can also add other things inside the page. So this is great if you have other information like notes and databases all in the same page, you can add a timeline this way. The other way you can add a timeline view is basically to convert the whole entire page into a database. So if you go to the bottom here and then you click the three dots here, you can go to timeline and the whole page gets converted into a timeline view database. So this is a database page, which means that you can't add additional notes or anything, but it's more secure in the sense that you can reference this database from outside of this page. The other way you can add a timeline view is by referencing timelines from another existing timeline view database. So if we go type linked view of database, we can locate a timeline view database from one of our existing databases. And another thing you can do is basically click plus new table and then go to the three dots here, go to layout, and then you can convert this into a timeline. But since it doesn't have a date property, it's not going to show any entries here, but it's a great way to transform your other databases, which might have dates, into a timeline view. So the first thing we wanted to show you is basically how to navigate a timeline view database. So when you have a timeline view, basically you can change the way that your timeline looks using this here. So you can see it in hours, day, week, bi-week, month, quarter, and year. And if you want to add new entries to your timeline, you can simply click into here, type the name. So for example, project one, and you basically have a timeline here. And if you open it up, you can see that the date is automatically July 9th to July 13th. And you can add things like tags and additional notes. If you want to see today, you can click today like this. And if you are scrolled here and you don't see any entries, you can easily go to your entries using these arrows like this. So in a timeline, the first thing you might want to do is to add useful properties. So some of the properties we like to add in a timeline view can be checkboxes to track whether or not your project or task has been done. So we like to add checkboxes like this. Additionally, tags can be useful. Let's say that this is the drafting phase of the project. So you could put something like drafting. And then if we click out, you can go to the three dots here, go to properties, and then choose to show these kinds of properties. It's very nice because you can see all the information here like this. The other thing we wanted to show you is that you can separate your start and end dates in timeline view. So if we open one of these up, we can see the start and end like this. However, if you decided to add another date, which is, let's say, end date, and then you can actually set it so that this is the start date and this is the end date. So if we close this and go to the three dots here and then we go to layout and then we can go to separate start and end dates by toggling this on, and then you can set the start date to be start date, the end date to be end date. And in this way, you can see two dates in one database view, which can be really useful. So the other thing we wanted to show you is that if you have lots of properties clouding your timeline, you can actually also turn on a table view at the same time. So if we go to the three dots here and then go to layout, you can go ahead and toggle on show table. And you can also choose which table properties should be shown. So let's say that we also want to see the tags. We could show it like this and drag it over. And what's also nice is that you can actually use the calculations of the table at the same time that you see your timeline view. And if you want to hide it, you can click hide table. If you want to show it, you can show table like this. The next thing we wanted to show you is that you can group all of your entries just like other database types. And to do that, you can go to the three dots here and go to group. And let's say you wanted to group it by tags, you can click tags and you can now see that everything is tagged by drafting inside of this grouping. Then one of our favorite features of Timeline View is when you do dependencies. So if you add another entry here, project 2, and project 2 cannot be completed until project 1 is done, then you can actually drag this arrow to project 2 like this and turn on dependencies. So that means that project 2 is dependent on project 1, and you can also have these various settings, like if you want to shift only when dates overlap, or shift and maintain a time between items, do not automatically shift. You can also turn on avoid weekends, shift using start date, separate start and end dates, and so on. And then you can just click turn on dependencies. So this is a really nice way to really see your timeline in this kind of flowing manner. It's a lot easier to see what kind of blockers there are to get to your goals. The next interesting thing to note when you're using Timeline View is the sub items. So if we go to the three dots here and then go to sub items and turn it on, another really interesting way to see your entries appears, which is this line here. So you can click like this, and let's say this is sub task. So you can really see your sub task like this, and it basically shows you an even more detailed view of your projects and how they lead to one to the next. A few smaller things that are really useful in Timeline View is your sort feature, as well as filtering and search. So if you wanted to search something specific, so you were looking for project 2, you can look for it this way. And if you want to sort it and make sure that you see what you want on the top, you can do something like start date, and you can sort it by descending, for example, if you wanted to see it this way. Other things you can do is to filter it. So if you have any specific filters you want to apply to your timeline view, you can also do so. And finally, we also wanted to mention that you can also open up your timeline view in calendar, because this is a date related database type. So you can also have your timeline in Notion while keeping track of your dates in your Notion calendar along with Google Calendar. We hope this was useful. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.